Good morning. I'm Arvi Cudala, married to Gloria, parents of two children, servants of God. We received the Lord back in 1992, just before we got married in 1993. When we received Jesus, the Lord removed our smoking and drinking habits. We eagerly learned more about Jesus by attending various Bible lectures in Makati, braving the traffic from Santa Mesa and home to Antipolo. We diligently attended worship, even if we had to leave right before the message to be able to get to work on time. We tithed, supported missions, and church initiatives to practice stewardship.
At work, we persevere to obey Colossians 3:23 and 24. Whatever you do, do your work heartily as for the Lord rather than for men, knowing from the Lord you will receive the reward of inheritance. It is the Lord Christ whom you serve. We work hard and aim to perform with excellence, integrity, and love. We also started Bible studies as well as special studies like PDL and Epicenter.
God blessed our careers as we advanced to top positions in the company we served. To our delight, God gave us day offs on Sundays starting 1998, so we could finally attend the entire service. However, in 2013, we realized we had not really done the one thing we should have been doing, which was to intentionally make disciples, not even our own family. Looking back, our obedience was only until the point of our comfort zone. Both of us felt it was awkward to pursue our office mates. We did not want others to get the impression that we were unduly using our authority.
At home, aside from failing to disciple our children intentionally, we realized we did not really know our kids anymore, who were then 18 and 14 years old already. Moreover, our quiet time and D group attendance was waning, and RV would often attend half asleep.
We decided it was time to take obedience seriously.
In 2014, I resigned to pursue discipleship. I revived my relationship with our children and eventually joined WOW to deepen my faith and to make disciples, which the Lord blessed.
In the same year, I decided to resign and join another company for career advancement and in hopes that a fresh start would result in office discipleship.
We even joined Welcome Wednesdays and the GLC series, but RV would frequently be half asleep again.
As I was heading a startup company, the pressures of work choked my discipleship efforts, and it did not bear fruit. So God stepped in. The mother company absorbed the new company I was working in, and the merger made my position redundant. I was out of a job by July 2016. But in obedience to God and His grace, we chose to be anxious for nothing. We chose to be still and to allow 1 year to focus on God's leading.
First, we had to be faithful with the little things. We went back to a regular quiet time and to reading the Bible in a year. We reduced our TV time and eventually cut it out altogether in 2017. We also started attending D group regularly and participating actively. Hindi na natutulog si RV during our Bible study time.
Then we pursued the Great Commission. From the WOW ladies under Gloria, we invited their husbands and eventually formed a D group together with friends we had made through the Welcome Wednesdays. We also started a devotion at home with our children, using even the drive to school to read verses. To help us share the gospel, we joined the Welcome Ministry and invested in simple tracts, which we would leave in restaurants with a tip. But we had one issue with provision.
We built up a retirement fund that we counted on to keep us in modest comfort, and we invested a large chunk with a friend. But it has been performing poorly, and we now have neither salaries nor a steady income. But God said in Matthew 6:33, "But seek ye first the kingdom, His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you." So we committed to trust in God and not in Mammon.
So far, the Lord has been faithful and has continued to bless us. Our relationship with our children is now stronger. They are willing to be discipled and to join church activities. We also have a D group of Timothys who are growing in the faith, and who accepted the challenge to disciple others.
As for our provision, God continues to meet for our needs and even allows us to continue tithing while sending us people to help us in finding a suitable business.
So we are Arvi
and Gloria Cudala,
striving for obedience to our Lord and Savior.
To God be all the glory.